guy could just say, hey, I've got some money. We want to get married, and can we get the papers? And they gave it to you, right? They didn't say, well, fill out this long survey. They gave it to you. And I just want, I want to give you an object lesson, okay? That's all your hard work. This is just paper. It doesn't make the marriage. And by the way, this is not the original. Okay? I can read that paper. It's not the original. I told you to trust me. I'm glad you did. I'm glad you didn't strike at me. You know what I mean? Okay, good. I'll hold tight. Which brings me to another point. That paper, that's all it is. It doesn't make the marriage. And which brings me to another point. If problems arise between the two of you, and they will, if problems arise and you need to talk to someone, talk to someone who will keep it confidential and someone who will be out for both interests. You don't want someone to say, well, I told you not to marry him, or I knew she was going to be like that. You don't want that kind of person in your life. In fact, as soon as those words come out of their mouth, you say, you know, it's been nice talking to you. And you move on, and you find someone who will respect and honor your relationship and try to be a part of the building process, the solution, and not part of the problem. So, with that in mind, in order to keep the Ten Commandments of marriage, this is the bottom line. Make the Lord the core, the foundation of your marriage. In 1 John chapter 5, verse 8, the Bible says this, that God is love. As you experience God's love and grow in His love, your marriage will be strong. It will be able to endure the challenges and obstacles of life. John 15, verse 5 says this, I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. He also tells us this, for without me, you can do nothing. And Philippians 4:13, if we were to retranslate that verse, it says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. As a couple, you need to say this, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. And now the moment you've been waiting for, the vows. And if you will look into my eyes and repeat these words, look at him. Look at him. Penetrate his mind here, Annie. And repeat after me. I, Annie, take you, Eric, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness or in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. And here too, I pledge you my faithfulness. And here too, I pledge you my faithfulness. The rings, please. Do you have the ring? And with this ring, I thee wed. Now, Eric, if you'll repeat after me, but we have the rings for him. I, Eric,
take you, Annie,
to be my wedded wife,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness or in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. And here too, I pledge you my faithfulness. And with this ring, I thee wed. Did y'all hear that?
Yes.
The lighting. Oh, I'm glad. If you would have heard that, he said dreams do come true.
Oh, man.
The lighting of the unity candle symbolizes your union in marriage. Jesus said, therefore a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast, united, joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh, so they are no longer two but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no one come between them. Let us pray. Father, again, as we come before your throne,